go to 7-Eleven, I buy some stuff.
11-11.
Lucky 11s.
I look at the date, it's 11-11. I look at the time, it's 11-11. I start to see these 11s everywhere. When I followed them, I found these eyes.
So I walked into this movie blind.
I didn't want to know what it was about. I just knew that you both were involved, and I'm a huge fan of you both. Okay. And that was good enough for me. And so I'm...
That's cool. Yeah. That is the coolest thing in the world.
Yeah.
That's nice. That's so cool. How did we do? Did we deliver, or were you like, yes. I'm no longer on these guys' radar anymore?
Mm-hmm. It's one of the best movies I've seen this year, easily.
Wow.
Wow, so, thank you, yeah. Preston. Thanks, man.
No problem. But it's one of those movies where I walked into it, like I walked in with my own ideas about life and the world, and then I left the theater feeling completely different and in the best way possible.
That's amazing.
But it's like there's life before this movie, and then there's life after this movie. And so I'm curious to know if you've ever had an experience like that with any movies that you've watched growing up or maybe recently.
Wow. Are you on camera too?
Yeah.
That is good, because that's the best part of this interview right there. That was wonderful. That was a really, yeah, the most beautiful thing I've heard. And we've been on the road for so long. That's one of the most beautiful things I've heard.
I wish everyone could see the movie like that.
Yeah.
You know, it's such a catch-22. You want to, you need to promote the movie. You need to, you need people talking about the movie. You need a trailer and stuff.
Yeah.
But in particular, this movie, you kind of feel like, I wish that people could just walk in not knowing, not having any idea of what it's about and just experiencing it.
I could tell you three movies in my life. I remember when I was about 18 years old, it was one stretch of a week that I saw Steven Soderbergh's Sex, Live, and Videotape, mm-hmm. Julian Schnabel's Basquiat, and Krzysztof Kieślowski's Red. And my head exploded. And I realized what cinema was. Before that, I watched Die Hard and stuff like that. I like Die Hard. Die Hard's rad. And the first one was the first rated R movie I ever saw in my life. I remember I was 8 years old and I watched Die Hard 1. That didn't do that, what you just said. Those other movies did that, what you just said.
Yeah. What about for you?
What's the question?
Have you ever seen a movie that when you went in it changed you? When you walked out, you were like, the world looks different.
When I think the first time I saw a movie where I was like, I guess that's not a movie, that's a film.
Yeah.
Was I bought this VHS tape when I was a kid, maybe 12 or 13. I bought Drugstore Cowboy. It was a box full of cassette VHS tapes, mm-hmm. in a flea market in Pennsylvania or something. Mm-hmm. And there was Drugstore. It was two of Gus Van Sant's movies: Drugstore Cowboy, My Own Private Idaho.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, when I watched those two films, I'd never seen anything like that before. And it really, I was like, wow.
I can totally picture you at 12. In a flea market in Philadelphia, doing that. That's such a cool image.
Yeah.
And you're like, what's this? And this.
Yeah. But it completely changed. It completely changed the way I thought about film.
Yeah.
Yeah, because it's a language. That's the thing. Film's a language. Or it's like a... It's a...
Sorry, I don't mean to cut you off.
Yeah, seriously, he does this all the time.
But it was the first time that I saw, the hero not get the girl. And it was the first time I saw it. And I was so, it affected me, you know? I was like, is it over?
Right, that's what's supposed to happen?
Yeah.
Because so many movies are the person wants to win, and do they win or do they lose? And then they win.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the structure of 99% of
American movies. Yeah.
Yeah.
I remember, I don't even think I liked it the first time. The first time, it screwed up my radar so much that I was like, oh, I guess it's bad. I guess it's a bad thing. But then it kind of stuck in my mind. Then I watched it again, and then I got, I'm really into films that you can watch over and over and over and over again.
Me too.
I think you can do that with this film,
Yeah.
What's great about this film, and it's been people have said this in screenings, so You know, which is one thing that I was wondering. There's so many little things, especially from the period in which you started writing, there's so many little things that you can't pick up.
But everything's relevant, yeah.
And there's so much symbolic, you know, symbolism in the film.
When I saw you, I had the feeling that I had known you. Like, we are connected from past lives.
I don't believe in that.
What do you believe in?
I'm a scientist, I believe in proof.
Every person on this planet has their own unique pair of eyes.
You ever feel like when you met someone, they fill this hole inside of you?
Are you okay, man?
Yeah, okay.
The way you talked was like poetic.
There's a line in the film that really stood out to me, and it's in the trailer, I think, where you say everyone has their own unique set of eyes and perspective of the universe. What's your perspective of the business that you're in?
Oh. I like the business, to be honest. I think it's, you mean like the numbers? Like, I studied economics and I like numbers. I like to know how much things cost, how much they're marketed for, how much they make. Like, that side of it is totally engaging to me in a way that sports may be engaging to some people. Right. Like, I love that. But then I love the art form as a satisfying feeling in life. And, you know, I don't know. What do you mean in particular?
Like, because you're in the film business. Like, what's your perspective?
It's a cutthroat business, Preston. Get out now. Get out now when you still can.
I still can.
But you still care about life.
It's gonna totally ruin you.
The way I feel about the, you know, it's an interesting question. I think that, this business, the business. You mean in particularly the business of the film industry?
Well, film and TV for you, but just this, that whole thing.
I'm an artist, man. So yeah. I'm not a good businessman. You know? Like I was gonna, you know, like basically if we went to a bar right now, you'd be buying the drink. You know, I'm not. I have strengths, you know. You have strengths and you have weaknesses. My strengths are definitely the creative. I know it's kind of all I know how to do, really. Really, everything else I'm just a mess. Business wise, I'm a mess. I never got into it for the business aspect of it, and so that can be hard. It can be hard at times. It can be very frustrating at times because sometimes I don't understand. I don't understand. But I think that where we are in cinema right now is a really interesting place. Yeah. I mean, I think based on technology, where we're at with technology, I feel like it's a really exciting place to be for filmmakers.
Yeah.
Because you could always kind of do this, but now I think it's certainly a lot easier if you look at history. If you're a filmmaker and you're trying to make films, I think it's plausible.
Yeah,
you
completely.
Can do it.
You have to have some tenacity and like heart, like a lot of work. But you know, yeah. It's right. The access to it is there. And I mean, we're lucky. Like, Fox Searchlight is one of the few remaining indie majors, and they've been really, really supportive, and they like believe in auteurship and long trajectory of careers and stuff. And so,
yeah, they've been awesome.
They've been really awesome. They've been good.
They haven't really been fitting the cliche.
Yeah, not at all. They're like, yeah, it's like
at all, really.
Yeah, I mean, they fly us on the private jet everywhere. Yeah. No, I'm just kidding. And yeah, like right now we're getting our foot massaged. It's like off camera.
You can't see it.
You can't see it. Yeah, business is all right. Business is part of life, I guess.
Yeah.
But the art is like the thing that you do.
Sure. Well, thank you so much.
Oh, that's the whole thing.
That's the whole thing.
Could have talked to you all day.
Thank you, man. It's really, really nice to meet you.
So much.